everyone and welcome back. So today we are going to talk about manufacturing module in Odoo. Manufacturing is a procedure of changing our crude materials or segments into completed merchandise or items. For an organization which handle enormous amount of manufacturing items, they need to follow each manufacturing request proficiently. The manufacturing module under Odoo helps the end user to deal with the intricacy of production, manage bill of materials, plan manufacturing orders, and track work orders and so on. So manufacturing module is one of the fundamental application in Odoo. So let us see more about this module. If you come to this module, you can see a work centers overview, which contains overview of all the work centers that you have created. Here, assembly line 1, drill station 1, assembly line 2, these are all the work center name, and you can create work orders from here, and you can see all the work orders that are in progress and the OEE. OEE means overall equipment effectiveness, and if a work center has some work orders in progress, you can see in green color, then in this work center, you can see it has no work orders in progress, and you can also block a work center. If you click this, you can give some reason for the blocking, like material availability, and you can give some description and block this work center. So we will see more about work centers later. Now we can move on to creation of bill of material. A bill of material is a necessary factor in order to create manufacturing order for a product. That is, to manufacture a product, a bill of material is a very important thing. So now we can create a bill of material and add for which product we are creating the bill of material. Then we can specify a product varying here. So this bill of material is applied to that variant only. Then you can specify the quantity here, in what quantity, and you can give the units, then routing. You can add in what routing this bill of material need to be created. So this routing contains some work centers and some work orders through which a product passes. So we will see about routing later, more about later. Then components. You can add components under this bill of material. So for creating, manufacturing this cabinet with doors, we need some components that can be added here. And the quantity of the component. For this component, I can give how much quantity I require. Then unit of measure. Then you can also apply this on variants, particular variant, and consume in operation. You can give the operation, in what operation it is consumed. Then you can also add remaining components of this product. Same way, quantity, unit of measure, variants, and in which operation you are consuming it. Then under byproducts, you can add byproduct for this bill of material. So these are some products that came as remaining of the manufacturing. You can add this product is a byproduct of this bill of material. And under miscellaneous tab, you can see manufacturing readiness. When components for first operation are available, when all components are available, that is, here you can see defines when manufacturing order is considered as ready to be started. So you can set if all components are only available, then only manufacturing need to be started, can be started. This can be set here. Or otherwise, if some components are available for first operation, then manufacturing can be started. In that way, you can set here. Then version. You can specify the version of this bill of material. Then consumption. Consumption means sometimes you have specified some components quantity here. Sometimes during manufacture you require more quantity. And if it is strict, consumption is strict, then more will not be provided. only the components quantity specified here will be provided. And in the case of flexible, then according to requirement, you can give more components, that is more quantity. Then operation, you can specify an operation here or create an add here. So that's all about the bill of material creation. Then after creation of the bill of material, you can create a manufacturing order for that product.
Now let us create a manufacturing order for cabinet with doors. Let us go to the operations tab, take the manufacturing orders. So this is the page where we create manufacturing orders. Let's go and click on the create button. Then this is the page to create manufacturing order. Now let us add the product. Cabinet with doors. The quantity we are producing is 1. Bill of material is auto populated here and the routing is secondary assembly. If needed, we shall mention the deadline. Then the responsible person is Michel Admin. And if there is any source documents, we can add here. Also, we can mention the company name here. Now, under the components tab, we have few products. These are the products that we added in the bill of materials. So, having completed this form, we shall click on the mark as Odoo. Click on the check availability to ensure the availability of the component products. So the component products are available. Now we can plan the production. So we have planned. Now a new smart button we can see here, work orders. Click on it. These are the work orders that are necessary for the manufacturing of this product. Now we can see that the first work order is in the ready state and other two are waiting for another work order. This means that if we complete the first work order, only then the next work order will be in the ready state. Now let's take the first work order which is in the ready state. Here we can see few tabs. This is the work instruction. Here we can see the instruction of this work order. Now in the current production tab, here we can see the quantity in production. It is 1. And the component which is being added in this work center. Then the next tab is time tracking. Here we can see the planned date and effective date. Also the expected duration is shown here. It is 60 minutes and there is an option of real duration. Since we have not processed this work order, it is in the zero state, and if we start processing, this real duration starts running. Now we have finished steps and miscellaneous tabs. In the miscellaneous tab, we can see the work center of this work order and the manufacturing order. Now we shall process the work order. So this is the work order interface. Here we can see that the real duration starts run. And from this interface, we can pause the work order. Also, we have one drop down menu here. From this, we can block, scrap, also can send maintenance request and quality alert for this work order. Now we shall give a serial number for this work order. So if you have finished, click on the mark as done. When we finished the first work order, automatically the second work order is in the ready state. So let us take this second work order. Process it. If you have finished, click on the mark as done. And the next work order is in the ready state. Let's process it. Click on mark as done. So we have processed all the work orders. Now let's go back to the manufacturing order. Take the manufacturing order of cabinet with doors. Here in this smart button we can see that all the three work orders have completed. Now let us click on mark as done. So we have completed this manufacturing order. Now under the operations tab we have few more options. We have scrap orders. One of the most useful features of Odoo is that it provisions the end user to create scrap at any stage of production line. One will be enabled to view a scrap button almost all the stages of production line. Upon clicking the scrap button, Odoo creates an instant scrap entry in the inventory. For a better understanding regarding the scrap management, click on the video link shown above. Now we have the option of unbuilt orders. Utilizing the Odoo manufacturing module, the end user can seamlessly unbuild the products. One can unbuild the product that are built by themselves or can unbuild the products that are received. For a better understanding regarding the unbuilding of orders, click on the video link shown above. Now here are the option of work orders. Here we can see all the work orders that we have processed till now. These all are the work orders that we have processed here. Here we can see the scheduled date start. Under week's work center this work order has been processed. Then the manufacturing order, manufactured products, each work order status, everything can be seen here. Let us go back.
Now let us move on to planning of work orders. Here you can see work orders, planning by production, planning by work center. So planning by work production. Okay. Here you can see some of the manufacturing orders and the work orders within each manufacturing order. This is a work order for cabinet with doors, and you can see that order that is packing, start date and stop date and the work center name of that work order. So these are all some of the work orders of this manufacturing order, and these can be filtered by in progress, that is the work order in progress and work orders in ready state, pending, finished, available and all. And we can also group these work orders based on work center, manufacturing order and status. We can also group this by year, that is the schedule date, and you can add some to the current search. You can also see these work orders planning by day wise, week wise and year wise. Then we have planning by work center, that is this is planned according to work center. You can see the planning based on the work centers. It is just grouped by work center. That is only the difference you can see. And same way you can filter these all. Then we have a cool feature in Odoo, that is master production schedule. For that we need to go to configuration settings. Here we have under planning master production schedule. Plan manufacturing orders or purchase order based on forecast. So if we tick this one and save this, you can see time range. Time range of the master production schedule that need to be displayed. It can be monthly, weekly. So I'm just selecting this weekly. You can see default value for the time ranges in master production schedule report. And you can add number of columns that we need. So just we can move to this master production schedule. So here we have the master production schedule with the 12 columns that we have specified in that configuration settings. So this MPS, that is master production schedule, provides overall information about the manufacturing plan, and we can make a clear idea about the expected orders. Here we can analyze all demands or requirements and prioritize them, and we can maintain the proper flow of production so that our manufacturing and replenishment processes works with proper speed and efficiency. So we can add a product to this schedule. We can choose a product. And you can specify the production warehouse, which warehouse. Then safety stock target. So safety stock target means it is a stock that we need to have at the end of the period. Let us give it as. Then we can add the minimum to replenish, how much to be replenished with minimum. Then maximum to replenish, let us give it as 1000. Okay, you can save this. So when you save that, you can see that product is added here. For the scheduling of that product, you can see some lines. And you can see some fields like starting inventory, demand forecast, to replenish and forecasted stock. So under rows, you can add whatever you need here. I'm just adding actual demand that I need, actual replenish and quality promise. So now we have some extra fields here. Then you can see the production schedule for this product. When you click this one, you can again see that, and you can again edit that. So if I wish to edit the safety stock, then again also I can edit this one. And that thing, that is a safety stock, you can see under this forecasted stock, that is 9, that we have just added. Now we need to estimate the demand in a period. A demand can occur in a period. For that we have a field demand forecast that can be edited manually. So you can edit this. So in this period you can expect this much demand, that can be added here. And you can see an actual demand. Actual demand means what demand actually came. So the confirmed demand based on the confirmed sale order. If you create a sale order, if some sale order is created and confirmed, automatically this value will change. You can see too, this is the actual demand for a product. That is for a product, here it is LED lamp. Then you have the starting inventory of this product. That is a forecasted quantity in stock at the beginning of the period. Here it is 3. So our on-hand quantity is 3, and we have to replenish, that is the quantities that need to be replenished. And you can see the actual replenishment. If some replenishment is done, then that value can be seen here. That is, replenishment means sending some RFQ in order to purchase some product. So if you click this, you can see the actual replenish changes. So before it was 6, now it is changed to 106 as per the to replenish. And each period, in the each period you can see 10. This is because the minimum to be replenished we have specified in the condition that it is 10. That is the reason why it is minimum 10. Then you also have a replenish button here. This will replenish the every products that we have added in this production schedule. Okay, then you can see a negative color. This is for a forecast stock. You can see negative color because it has gone below the forecasted stock, minimum stock target that we have set in this condition. And if it goes below that, then it will turn red color, and it is currently red color and also negative. Then you can see a green color. This is because we have only just specified the quantity of production that should be replenished to reach the expected safety stock. Then this can change to red color if the actual replenishment goes above this 50, that is to replenish. If it goes below above 50, it will change to red color, and it becomes orange in color if this is so much below this actual replenishment is so much below this to replenish. And this can have a gray color if both are equal. Below you can see this one is in gray color only because these two are equal measure. Then you have a formula for forecasted stock, that is starting inventory minus demand forecast plus to replenish. Then one more thing you can see is available to promise, that is the quantity predicted to be available for the sale at the end of the period. And this also has a formula, that is to replenish minus actual demand. So in this way you can schedule master production.
Now we shall go to the master data. Here we have few options. First of all, products. These all are the products that we have in our warehouse. Now we have the option of product variance. Each product can have some variance based on some attributes, which can be color, brand, size, and so on. So all the variants are shown as separate products in this page. Now we have the option of bill of materials. We have already discussed this bill of material in the beginning of this session. Now we have lot and serial number. These are used to track the products. Lot numbers are used to track products as a group, and serial numbers are unique numbers given for each product. For a better understanding of lot and serial numbers, click on the link shown above. Now we have the option of routing. Routings have the records of production operation or stages that one must follow in order to produce the finished products. So these all are the routes we have already created here. Let's go create one. So this is the form that has to be filled to create new routing. First of all, let's give a name for the routing. Assemble goods. This is the version of this routing, and company is mentioned here. Now we have the tab works and operations. Click on add a line to add operations here. This is the pop-up window or form to create operations. Let us create an operation here. Let's give the work center under which this operation takes place. So we mentioned the work center and company is mentioned here. Now we have the duration computation. So here we have two options: compute based on real time and set duration manually. If we select compute based on real time, then a new field appears. Here we have to add the number of last work orders based on which the real time is calculated. We can set it as duration manually. Then we have the tab worksheet. Here we can upload the PDF or Google Slide files of the work order. Let's save and close. So we have configured the routings. Now let us save it. So these routings are added in the bill of materials of a product. To add routing to a bill of materials, take the bill of materials. So this is the bill of materials. While we creating, here we have the option of adding routing. So by clicking here, we will get all the routings we have created. If you click on search more, we can see all the routings. This is the route we have just created. Click on it. So this is how we add routings to the bill of materials.
Now let us see the configuration of WorkCenters. Under master meta, you can see WorkCenters and some of the WorkCenters created: assembly line 1, drill station 1, assembly line 2. So we can create a new WorkCenter where we can give a WorkCenter name. Then you can add alternative WorkCenters. If this work center is busy with some other orders, you can redirect to some other alternative work centers. You can create an alternative work center here. And you can add as many work centers, alternative work centers you need. Then here you can give a code for the work center. Then you have working hours. Here it is standard 40 hours per week. This is the working hour of the work center. If you go to the external link, you can see the working hours and some of the shifts, that is schedules, in each day from some time to a different time. Then start date, end date can be seen here. It's with average hour per day and time zone and full time. So in this way you can add the working hours of the workstation. And under general information, you can see production information that contains some fields like time efficiency of this work center and capacity, that is the number of pieces, number of quantities that can be produced in parallel in this work center. You can give here. Then OEE. OEE means overall effective efficiency target in percentage. So how much target we need for this work center can be specified here. Then you have time before production, that is the time need for the setup of this work center before starting the production, and time after production, that is to clear or reset or clean this work center to start another production. Then you have costing information for this work center, with cost per hour for this work center. When you are producing something in this work center, per hour some cost can be given. Then you can add analytical account for this work center. Under description, you can add description for this work center. Then under equipments, you can add equipments required for this work center for production. So you can add as many you want. And you can see the technician responsible for this equipment and equipment category. So this HP laptop belongs to category computers and woodcutter belongs to furniture tools. Then you have MTBF. This is mean time between failure of this equipment and mean time to repair this equipment. Then you have estimated next failure, that is the failure when the failure can occur. The next failure can occur. Here you can see this. There is a date, and we will see about this equipment, configuration of equipment later. Okay, now you can see the lowest hours of this work center. some hours may be lost due to equipment failure or some other failures, and that can be viewed here. And load, the working load of this work center, like working hours in minutes, can be shown here. Then performance of this work center. Then one important thing is the overall equipment effectiveness, and that percentage can be seen here if it is calculated. So we can see an overall equipment effectiveness of some other workstations. In the overview, you can see some two of them are in 100%. And if you just open this OE, here you have a pie chart view, and fully productive time is in blue color, and this is fully productive time, and it is 100%. And you also have a pivot view for this. Here you can see the fully productive time in duration, total fully productive time, and the total overall equipment efficiency of this work center. So if you divide this fully productive time by this total overall equipment efficiency, you will get the overall equipment effectiveness. So you can see, if you divide this by this, it will be 100%. Then we can move on to reporting of manufacturing orders, work orders, overall equipment effectiveness. So this is a graph view for our manufacturing orders. We can select some measures like total quantity to produce. According to that, this will change, and we can filter this view by confirmed manufacturing orders, planned, in progress. These all can be viewed, and it can be grouped by routing, product, material availability, and schedule date. Same way, you also have a pivot view for this manufacturing orders reporting. Then we can move on to work orders. This is a reporting session of work orders. Here you have some measures like capacity, current product produced quantity, duration per unit, expected duration, quantity. You can select according to capacity, duration, quantity now. And then you have filters like done work orders, ready, and some are in pending. You can see the pending work orders here, and it can be grouped by some custom group can be added, and you can specify the time range that you need some work orders of last 5 years. Okay, that can be viewed here. And for this work orders, we have pivot view, list view, camp view. Then under reporting, overall equipment effectiveness that you have seen before in different views. I have shown before how to calculate overall equipment effectiveness and the different views. You have seen it before.
Under manufacturing module, we have few more sub-modules like maintenance, repair, quality, PLM, and so on. Now let us go and have a look into the maintenance module. This is the maintenance module. This is the dashboard of the maintenance module, and here we can see all the maintenance teams. Under the configuration, we have the options to create maintenance team and equipment categories. If we take maintenance team, here we can create maintenance team. Maintenance team, and we can add members to this team. We can add members as we wish. So we have created maintenance team. Also, we are able to create equipment categories here. These are all the available categories. clicking on the create button, we have the form to create category. Construction tools, this is a category. Under this category, we can create various equipments later. Click on save button. Now, coming to maintenance tab, we have maintenance request and maintenance calendar. Here we are able to make request for maintenance. Click on the create button. This is the form to create maintenance request. Let us go and check the already created request. Click on edit button. So this is a request we have already created, preventive maintenance. Here we can assign this maintenance work to a team. Here we can see all the teams we have created. We can assign to any of them. And the responsible person is machine admin here. We can also schedule the date for this maintenance. Also, we have the duration of this maintenance work. And if we need to give any priority, we shall give it here. Now we have the option to give the name of the person who creates this maintenance order. Now we have the option to add equipment for maintenance. Equipment category is given here. Now the request date is auto-populated here. We also have the option of maintenance type. Here we have corrective maintenance and preventive maintenance. Preventive maintenance is done periodically in order to decrease the probability of occurrence of its failure. It is performed while equipment is still working. Then corrective maintenance. It is done when a failure or issue occurs so that faulty equipment can be re-established to an operational condition. We also have the field to add the manufacturing order here. So this is the maintenance request. Then we also have maintenance calendar. This is the maintenance calendar. Clicking on any date, we can create a maintenance request from here. So this is the pop-up window to create maintenance request from this calendar view. We can create any maintenance request from here. So we have created a maintenance request from the calendar view. Now we have the tab of equipments. Under equipments, we have two options: work centers and machine and tools. From the option of machine and tools, we can create equipments for our work orders. Clicking on create button, we will get the form to create equipments. We shall check an already created equipment. This is the equipment of woodcutter. Here we can see the under which category this woodcutter comes, the company, also who is using this equipment. It is used under department or used by an employee or others. Since we have given employee here, we have to mention which is the employee. We have to mention the name here. Also the maintenance team who is maintaining this equipment is assigned here, and the technician. Also, we have given the work center here under which work center this equipment is used. We also have product information tab here. Here we can see from which vendor we have bought this equipment. Its effective date, cost, model, serial number, everything is shown here. Then we have maintenance tab. Here we have preventive maintenance frequency. We have given 5 days here. That means after 5 days we have to service the equipment. Then maintenance duration, how much time we take for the maintenance. Then we have expected mean time between failures. We have given here 14 days. That means we expect to have another failure after 14 days. Then mean time between failures. This is the real time between two failures. Then estimated next failure. This is the expected time of next failure. Then the option of latest failure and mean time to repair. So we have configured the equipments. Now under equipment tab we have the option of work center. We have already discussed work center in this video. Now let's go to reporting. This is the maintenance request report. Here we have different views of this report. We also can filter this report as we wish. Also can group by. So this is the maintenance module.
Now let us discuss quality management. Quality management is necessary in business to ensure customers are getting good quality products. At different stages of business, the product's quality is checked. So let us move on to this module. In the quality overview, you can see some of quality teams that was created, and you can create new quality team from the configuration. Okay, I'm creating a new quality team. You can give the quality name, team name. And you can give an email alias for this quality team and the company name, and you can save this. So in this way you can create team, quality team, and in the overview you can see for each team if there are quality alerts that can be viewed and the checks that are in progress. Here you can see some of the checks are in progress for this team, that is count 9, 7. Then under quality control you can see control points. So you can create quality control points for some products at different type of operation. It can be while delivering the product and while receiving product and manufacturing product. So in these steps, in these operations, you can set some control points. You can see some of the control points created for this is filtered according to product. So for this product you can see a reference number, then type of operation to which the quality control point is created, and the type of the quality checking, then teams to which team it is assigned, and the company name. And in this way you can create quality control points. So you can see some fields to create control points where title of this control point can be given, and the product, you can add product here and the product variant to which specifically this control point will be applied, and the operation to which you need to apply this quality control point. It can be, I have said you before, it can be while receiving that product or delivering the product or during manufacturing. So while you add the operation as manufacturing, you can see a work order operation came. You can add a work order here. That is, work order operation can be added here to which this control point will be created. Then company name and control type. Control type can be given to all operations, or it can be done randomly or periodically. If you click periodically, then control frequency, that is every how much days. You can specify as weeks, months and days. That is, it can be for 1 day, 2 weeks or 1 month. Like that way, periodically it will be. Then type. Type of control point. It can be test, like then take a picture, pass or fail, measuring. You have to give some measurement. Then only you can validate the operation. And you can add a responsible person for this quality control point. So in this way, you can create quality control points, and under message if failure, you can give a message if some failure occurs, and give some notes. And under instructions, you can give some instructions. Then you can see if there are some quality checks completed. You can see the quality checks here. Then under quality control, we have quality checks. So these are the quality checks that was done before, and you can see the status of each quality check. That is, it can be passed, to do, and it can be failed also. And you can see for each quality check the which product the quality check is done, and if lot number is given, that can be viewed here. Then the check date, the date at which the quality check was done, and check by which person, and the team, quality team responsible for this quality check, and the company. Okay, if you edit this, you can see the product name, lot, then you can see the order, control point of this quality check, and the team, company. So these are some of the checks. Then under quality control, we have quality alerts. You can create some alert. This can be done from the manufacturing of the product. At the time of manufacturing, there is an option that you have seen before in this video, that you can create alert at the time of production. And you can create quality alert from here also. So in this case, you can see two of the quality alerts are in new state, and it can be moved to confirm stage and action proposed. Some action is proposed for this quality alert, and if it is sold, it can be moved to sold state. So if you create one, you can see many fields like title of the quality alert, production, product name. Then if it is specifically applied to a product, it can be given product variant, it can be given here. Then the lot number, work center at which you give the quality alert, and the team responsible for it, quality team, and the responsible person. Some tags can be given for this quality alert. Then the root cause for the quality issue, it can be like work operation, work center failure, and priority given for this quality problem, quality alert. Then can give some description, and corrective actions can be suggested, and preventive actions. Then under miscellaneous tab, you can add the vendor and company and date assigned. Then just save that. So in this way, you can create quality alert. Then under reporting, you can see quality checks, reporting of all the quality checks with some measures, with measure done, then finished product sequence number, and some other filters like quality checks in progress, passed, failed, with some check date. You can filter these quality checks, and you can also group them according to product, control point and team, then within some time range. Then under reporting, you can see quality alerts, reporting of all the quality alerts with measures, that is count of quality alerts, and filters like done quality alerts, in progress one, and it can be grouped according to stage, responsible person, and the root cause of this quality alert. So in this way, you can see the reporting of quality. So for a better understanding of quality management, just click on the above link.
Now let us move on to repair management module. This is the repair module. Here we shall create a reply order. This is the reference number of this repair order. We shall add a product which we want to repair. We are repairing the table. We shall also add the customer. And this is the quantity of product we are going to repair. And this is the location from where we are taking this product. If need, we shall mention the warranty. And there is the option of invoice method. Here we can invoice this before or after the repair. We shall give it as before repair. And the price list of this customer is automatically filled here. Then under the tab of parts, we can click on add a line. Here the repair is, we can add or remove the parts of this product. Here we shall add a product. We shall add the leg for this product. Quantity of this product which we are going to add. And source location and destination location is here. So after having filled the necessary fields, let us click on confirm repair. After confirming and before the repair, we have to create the invoice for this customer. So we have created the invoice. Now we shall start the repair and end repair. After that, going to the invoice, we can post it and make the payment for this repair. Validate it. So we have made the payment. Under configuration, we have a repair order tags. Clicking on create button, we can create tag. We have created a tag called damage. So this is the repair management module. For a better understanding of this repair module, click on the video link above.
Now let us talk about PLM module, that is Product Lifecycle Management. This module mainly deals with engineering change orders. That is a documentation that contains change orders for bill of material, routing, then work instructions or changes in specifications. So let us move on to the module. So in the PLM overview, you can see engineering change order type and you can configure that too. So under configuration, you can see ECO types. There is only one ECO type created. You can create new ECO type and give a name for it. And you can also give an email alias for this. So a new ECO type is created and in the overview you can see that. Then let us talk about the engineering change orders. So here are some of the change orders that was created and moved to effective stages. Now let us create an engineering change order. Give a short summary for the change order. Then you have to give the type, that is the ECO type, engineering change order type. Okay, let us add the newly created furniture revision, and it is applied on. It can be applied on product only. Then you can give the product name, and it can be applied on bill of materials. Then routing. If you choose routing, you can see a field routing, and you can add the routing. Then BOM and routing. That is, the change can be done to both BOM and routing. So let us change the bill of material and add the product. Then automatically the bill of material of that product came. Then you can add the company name, then responsible person for this effectivity. So it is effective as soon as possible, and you can specify a date here. At that time it need to be effective. So I am just giving it as soon as possible, and you can create tags and add here. Then under note tab you can add notes, then approvals. Under approvals, if you have created some approvers for each stage, it will be visible here. I am just saving this one. So in this way you can create engineering change orders. Then the thing is that you need to make some changes in the stages. So in this case you can see for the stage, new stage, you can see the type of ECO type and whether it need to be folded in the view or allow to apply changes. And for some stages you can tick this one to apply changes, and when it is a final stage you can mention here. Then under the approvals you can add the approvers. Here it is just only comments only, and sometimes we need to add approval type as it is required to approve, and you can add the users and the role. So in this way you can edit the stages. Okay, now I am just opening this and starting a new revision. Okay, I have started revision. Then I can move it to new state, then to progress state, and if I open this I can see two buttons, approve and reject. And under approvals I can see approval is required by this Michelle admin, and if you open this you can see approval stages in progress and status not yet. So from here itself this can be approved or rejected. I am just approving it. So this is approved. So only after approval we can move to the next stage. Okay, I am moving to validated, and from here also you can see a button that is approve or reject. So before that let us move on to the BOM revision, and we can edit here, and you can add a new component. Okay, I am adding a new component and just saving that. Then I can approve that suggestion. Okay, this is approved. Then I can move this to effective state, and I can approve and apply changes. So the change that was proposed is applied for that product. That is to change the bill of material where we have added a new component. Then we can just go to the bill of material and just see that product that we have, the bill of material of the product that we have just changed. Okay, here it is, table empty. Under miscellaneous tab you can see the version of this product has changed. Before it was 4, now it is changed to new version, that is 5. So in this way you can change the bill of material, product and routing of those products. Then under master data you can see routings, work centers that we have already discussed. Then under configuration we have some ECO stages, those stages that we have seen in the ECU. You can create more stages, and we have already talked about ECU types. Then also you can give ECU tags for engineering changes. You can give tags. Now let us move on to reporting of engineering change orders. Here you can see measures like BOM revision, color, routing. According to these measures, you can see the engineering change orders. Then some filters like my change orders, that is Michelin means change orders, and awaiting validation, then to do, in progress. In that way, you can filter change orders. Then it can be grouped according to stage, product, company and all. And for this engineering change order, we have a PO view too. For a better understanding of this module, just click the video link above. So we have covered all the submodules under manufacturing. So that's all about this module, and thanks for watching.
If you are interested in knowing more about this or looking for any Odoo implementation or customization in your business, drop your request to info@cybrosys.com.